Let us take a look at the different types of dynamic RAM cells that are available. So first are the asynchronous DRAMs. Here the timing of the memory device is controlled asynchronously. That means there is no clock which is driving the operations, and the memory controller circuit will generate the required control signals to control the timing. Also, some handshaking protocols will be put in place to control the synchronization between the memory and the processor, or between the memory and the I/O devices. Also, since there is no inbuilt circuitry for this, the refreshing of the cells is also generated by some external signals. Next, we have the synchronous DRAMs. Here, the operations are synchronized with a clock signals. So the access speed of the chip is also directly synchronized with the clock of the processor. These, they have a built-in refresh circuitry, and they are commercially available as modules, and each module will have multiple SDRAM chips depending upon the capacity that is required. Then we have the double data rate synchronous DRAM. This is a faster version of the synchronous DRAM because it can perform operation on both edges of the clock signal. That means at the rising edge of the clock signal also the memory can be accessed, and at the falling edge also. So the data transfer rate in this manner is doubled. And to access the memory at such high rate, the memory cells are organized into two groups, and each group can be accessed separately. Then we have the Rambus DRAM. These are again synchronous DRAMs, and they provide a very high data transfer rate over the CPU memory bus. And they use various speed up mechanism like a synchronous memory interface. Then they have some caching mechanism also available inside the DRAM chips, and very fast signal timing. So these were the different types of DRAMs that are available.